So hi, and welcome to the latest in the series of The Technologists with me, one of the managing partners of Active Digital Marketing Communications, Lou A.L. Samurai. And today what I'm going to talk about, maybe even have a rant about in some senses, I suppose, is something that I feel is very important, and I think something that sort of crystallizes the 17 to 20 years of working in marketing and public relations in the region. So again, it's something that I think is very specific to the Middle East region. I'm not suggesting, nor do I have the experience or insight into how this might be in Europe or the US or even the Far East. So what I speak about today is something that we see very, very much here as a Middle Eastern issue. I'm sure there are some commonalities, but at the end of the day, I'm talking about this region. And I think it's very much a cliche or an analogy that we always use and have done for many years, in the sense of many things when it comes to the sort of purchase cycle for any kind of product or service. And that is something that we say is where, you know, you have to be careful in terms of what you're buying, but at the same time, you will get what you pay for. And of course, there are many analogies that people draw for this as part of their sales patter, if you like. Car analogies. There are analogies to certain food products that if you buy them cheap, they aren't quite as healthy or nutritious as the more expensive items. When you look at organic versus processed food, for example. So there are a lot of analogies and a lot of examples. But today, what I want to talk about is the issue of agencies and how it's quite incredible in some cases that today, agencies are being selected based on cost versus any other process, any other due diligence that clients really need to be going through, whether they're based here in the region or whether they're actually based outside the region. So what I'd like to do is kind of break this down a little bit and cover it off in sort of three topics. And I think the first is the region itself. So if we look at the region, if we sit back and take a good look at this region, many clients are looking at it from the perspective of it's just one homogenous block. And that is probably where we already start to go wrong, in my view. And that is because I think that when you sit back and you want to do that, it's like sitting back and looking at Europe as one homogenous block. We have within this region some 6 to 11 different markets that clients want to focus on and cover. So there are the obvious ones like the United Arab Emirates and Saudi Arabia. Then you're looking at somewhere in the region of Kuwait and Qatar and maybe Oman. And then you can widen that to Lebanon and Syria, Egypt, some of the North African countries. And to see it as one homogenous block and then to allocate the funds and resources for that is much like saying, well, I'm going to take Germany, France and the UK, lump them into one block and allocate a budget of $5,000 per month to do that, to cover that geographic region, whether it's through media and social media, whether it's just media focus, whether it's just a press relations exercise with some press bureau activity involved, it's still just not going to do the job as well. So at the end of the day, one of the challenges that any agency is going to find is to do that job with the budgets that they are normally allocated for a region versus a market. And I think that's an important distinction, and one that I think clients in Europe and the US and possibly the Far East don't always get. It's a nuance to them. And the fact that all these markets are quite different in terms of their profiles, behaviors, attitudes. And when we're talking about specifically in our area of expertise, which is business to business, so you're looking at technology, you're looking at finance, you're looking at fintech, health tech, the behavioral patterns, the outlooks may in some senses have some commonalities, but the languages, the nuances that you have to use are different. The media environments are different. So there is an element of customization that needs to go into all of those markets. And that means time and resources. And that means that it's a challenge for any agency to cover that time and resources with the budgets they're being given. And that is an issue. I think when it comes down to the local representation on the ground, what we find is that the majority of the people on the ground here are very sales focused. So for them, that kind of budget is conveniently fine because it sits within the sort of budget allocations they have where they'd like to allocate more money or resources to sales-driven activities, supporting their channel partners, whatever it might be. So I think that's one of the considerations that I think really, if this region is of any importance, and we believe that it is quite a profitable region for many companies, it may not be the largest in terms of consumer consumers and the populations that you look at. However, certainly in the areas of technology and gaming and fintech and health tech and these kinds of sectors that we focus on and specialize in, I think that you'll see that the populations are young, they're tech savvy, they are very early adopters. So again, we have an enormous potential within this region, and with all of the social and economic changes that are going on as we speak, Saudi being a prime example, I think that we do need to start looking and thinking of this region more as specific markets and how we're going to allocate activity and budgets to those markets. So that's kind of my first point, is let's look at the region differently. I think the second thing is that we have a distinction between the type of client that is looking at this region. And as I alluded to earlier and I mentioned earlier, I think that when you're looking at a European or a US or a Far East based client, what you have is you've got a person or a team who are looking at the various benefits that an agency can bring to their particular product or solution. And that is generally done long distance because they're doing that by maybe doing some research on a few websites, maybe they've taken some recommendations of names from their local sales teams, maybe they have been given references by their own agencies in Europe. However that process is handled, I think then it seems to go into a kind of email, possibly phone call kind of process. And that is interesting because I don't think that would be the case so much in Europe, the US or the Far East. I think that one of the key areas for any client is to go out and meet those agencies, see what kind of environment they have, look at the kind of people that are in that agency. Look, in some cases in the Middle East, look even if that agency actually has an office or whether it's just a one-man operation that talks or acts like it's an agency. Look at the kinds of things that agency is doing. You know, whether you want a press relations, media relations focused agency, or whether you want something that an agency like Active DMC offers, which is more integrated marketing as well as the core elements of PR, then you need to understand what sort of areas they have. Because it's a bit like, and again, I draw an analogy, but it's a bit like buying an iPhone and then only using it to make phone calls. You've got all this power in your hand, but yet you're only using it for one particular type of functionality. So you've paid 3,000 or 4,000 dirhams, nearly $1,000 for this implement, but you're only using something that actually you could have paid a couple of $100 for. So it's kind of a very, it's possibly goes against what I'm trying to say, but I think that you need to look at the potential and capabilities of those agencies. And the only way you're really going to know that beyond their website and what you're being told, and some of the case studies that possibly they send you, is to be able to visit the agency and see the kinds of people, see the spirit, see the work they're doing, hear how excited they are about it, or in some cases maybe not as excited as they should be about it. So that's something I think that is very important. And I think that that's talking and looking at it from a US-based, European-based, or Far Eastern-based client team. I think when we look at the local aspect of that, the regional teams, again, I go back to the fact that I think that it's very much a sales focused title or role that you see in this region. The larger organizations, I agree and I will say, do have marketing people involved, but I think that there is a view that they take a very tactical approach. they look at things very much in from an executional point of view, and that what happens is that you see that they're looking at things that are very price focused and very price sensitive. And again, you get back to that mentality of, well, I can pay little and get much. And at the end of the day, I think if you're looking at a consistent, sustained campaign or activity, whether it's a public relations focused one or it has a wider remit, that probably isn't going to work. And I've seen that many times myself. We've seen it as an agency where you get a lot of companies here in the region who then start to change agencies quite frequently. And that in itself has a negative effect on agencies like ourselves, who, when we see that or hear that, are not as enthusiastic to engage or to get involved with that particular company. And I think that that's an issue. And I think that therefore you get the local clients, and especially if they're passing back recommendations on agencies, they are looking at either very much from it from a personal contacts perspective, and they allow that to shape and focus their thinking throughout any kind of process, as well as the cost elements. And I have sat in front of clients even recently who you could see them giving me a value of what they thought the public relations activities should be, telling me how much they think it's worth. And in itself, that's kind of a concern. I mean, it's like going for a job interview and being told that, you know, we believe your salary is only, you're only worth this much in terms of salary and remuneration, rather than perhaps what you would normally do is ask that person what their salary expectations might be and look at those in line with their experience and knowledge and history of that particular role that you want them to be involved in. And I don't see it as being anything different when it comes to an agency. So having that kind of conversation, which I find is a very tactical one, can be quite frustrating. And also, I think when you do try to widen that discussion beyond a very tactical focus on press coverage or media relations, for example, you do tend to feel that there's two kinds of reactions here in the local market, and that is, one is fear, almost a panic of, I don't want to talk about those things, please. I want you to do this, and that's all I really want to talk about, rather than saying, okay, well, how else can you add value? That's interesting. How can that feed into what we're trying to do as a company, our objectives, who our target audiences are? It's more about, I want 12 press clippings a week or a month, and I want to see my MD in the newspapers and on the magazines and online. And as long as you're doing that, I'm happy, and you're doing it for a pittance, that's also fine, or half what it really is worth, that's even better. And I'll still call you every now and then and scream and shout at you for this not being right or that not being right. And that's really not a good relationship to have. And sadly, that is a relationship that I believe probably somewhere in the region of 60 or 70%. And I hasten to add, sadly, in this region, we don't have those kinds of statistics. And even our associations and bodies, professional ones in our own industry, don't really have any of those kinds of information to be able to tell us how many clients have that kind of relationship with their agency and how many agencies have that kind of relationship with their clients. It's a last minute crisis management knee-jerk day every single day. And that is something, again, where we come back to the title of this entire podcast, which is that it is about money, and you do get what you pay for. So you are going to get, in the end, low quality engagement. You're going to get demoralized or demotivated people who are working for your best interests and trying to communicate and promote your products. And you're going to get probably people who, because of the fact that they themselves have been cheaply hired, are probably not as qualified as those who have the experience and the knowledge and the know-how, or at the very least are in an environment where they can be, where they are being guided and helped to improve. And there is an attitude within that agency or organization that it always wants to improve and evolve and never just settle for the status quo, never settle for the lowest common denominator. And I do find that there's quite a few agencies, and we've seen clients go to those and choose them over us. That's fine. But at the end of the day, you are getting what you pay for, which is a very low level, very focused, very baseline activity. And when and if the occasion arises where that client wants to ask for something a little bit more or wants to push the agency a little bit harder, that's when you find the whole thing tends to unravel. And either they just end up accepting the fact that that agency is never going to really be able to do those things, and thus therefore limits the amount of activity and the effectiveness of activity in the region, or that's when you start to see the idea of, well, I think we should go out and repitch, and in most occasions, the same mistakes are made again. I'm sorry. So that's something that I think we see as a very, very distinct difference. And I think that what happens is that over time, the campaigns lose focus, and it's all about just delivering opportunities versus how do these align with our strategy? How do these align with our objectives? How do these align with what we're trying to achieve in the region? Are they effective? Are they delivering? And I think that's something that's sorely missing as part of the region and the focus on the region. The conclusion. So I think that, again, to conclude, is that when you look at these areas and you look at the agencies involved, you do need to understand who they are. You need to visit them. You need to physically go in and see their offices. I was saying to someone the other day, it's like, would you buy a car or a house without actually seeing it, without actually testing it, without actually trialing it? And the answer is probably no. So when you're putting that kind of amount of money on something, you want to make sure your investment is worthwhile and that it's going to pay off. Long term or short term. So I think that to conclude this is that it is an element of, if you aren't willing to go through those processes, if you aren't willing to look at the region in a way that is different, if you aren't willing to go through the due diligence of agency selection, you're going to find that you do get exactly what you pay for. And then that's really bad for us as agencies, because the chances are that's going to put you off doing anything in this region, or it's going to make you think that everyone's tarred with the same brush, everyone is exactly the same. And believe it or not, there are a few agencies in this region who are able to offer a much more added value service, but of course based on the right remuneration and the right kinds of costs and resources that remuneration is going to cover. And that is something that, if an agency is being transparent, will be able to show you and display to you. So I think that's really where I want to end this. I think that it's very, very important. And what I would love to have, and I think we'd all love to have here, generally around the technologist series that we're producing, but also around this specific podcast, is we want to hear your reactions. Maybe you don't agree with what I'm saying. Maybe it doesn't quite gel with your experience. Maybe you have had that experience. I was talking to a potential client at Jitex this last week, and his experiences actually, ironically, were very similar to ours. He had very much the same sense of feeling when he was dealing with his center, when he was dealing with his people back in Europe. So it is a frustration, even some clients, and it's very rare to hear that they also feel. So we'd love to hear from you. We'd love to hear comments. We'd love to hear feedback. We'd love to hear what you think. I would love to engage in any kind of discussion across any of our social media platforms about this particular issue, and I'm very happy to do that. And I would love to hear either similar or different viewpoints, and perhaps even have some anecdotal, or not anecdotal, but more factual feedback that either proves or disproves what I'm saying. This, as I said, comes from 20 years of working in this region, being involved and witnessing what's going on. So, I think that I've got a fairly, fairly good view, and I think it's fairly accurate, but I'm willing to be told otherwise. Thank you.